Hey guys, it's Alice here. I am going to spin the wheel and see what topic we're going to cover today. Okie dokie, we're talking about nitrous oxide. Awesome. Okay, nitrous oxide, another name for it, if you haven't heard of nitrous oxide, is laughing gas. So it's funny because I was going to say, as soon as it landed on nitrous oxide, I was going to say, oh, this is a new idea that is becoming popular in the U.S. for labor and birth. But it's kind of not actually accurate because it's an old idea that's coming back again. So nitrous oxide is using laughing gas during labor. So nitrous is something that used to be really popular. And actually, if you watch the show Call the Midwife, you might see the midwives carry something called, they call it gas and air. So gas and air is the same thing as nitrous oxide. And if you are not in the US, if you're in Canada or the UK, you might think that this is just a common option for pain management, for comfort in labor and birth, but actually not to us living in the US. So in the United States, this used to be an option for people in labor, but it sort of left our hospital systems and is now making a comeback. So depending upon where you live and where you'll be giving birth or what hospitals are in your area, this nitrous oxide might be available and might not. But what it is it's the one cool thing about it is that it is patient controlled. So it's something that you can start and stop. And it's all by putting a mask up to your face and breathing in and breathing out, still holding the mask. And then after you feel the effects, you can take it off, or at any time you want, you can take it off. And the cool thing about nitrous oxide is that it leaves your system very quickly. So it's something that won't have an effect on you for hours. That's different from another pain management option like IV narcotics. IV narcotics, once you have them in your system through an IV, it takes a while for your body to metabolize the drugs and for you not to feel the effects of them. So the nice thing, the pro really of nitrous oxide, is that you have complete control over when you're dosing yourself with it. And if you don't like the way that it feels, you can stop. So there's a lot of advantages as far as the ease of use. Nitrous oxide is also very cheap, so it's not something that's really expensive. It doesn't require a specialist to administer, like an epidural, so you wouldn't need an anesthesiologist. But what you do need is the equipment, and you need a hospital that supports nitrous oxide. So if this seems like something that you might want to use for labor, definitely ask your care providers and during a hospital tour if it's available. And if there's anything that you need, any special testing you need done, anything that needs to be prepped before that can be used. If nitrous oxide is something that you're interested in using and you think that that might be an option, make sure you let your care team know when you are in labor so that they have enough time to get the equipment out. Sometimes especially in a facility that maybe hasn't been using nitrous a lot, they might not have all of their nurses trained on nitrous. They might not have checked the tanks to make sure they've been replaced if they get empty and that kind of thing. So it's always good to give your team a heads up and say, you know, I'm hoping to go without an epidural, but I would really like to take advantage of nitrous, I think, in later labor. So, you know, is there anything that we need to do to get it ready? That's something partners can always ask your nurse to, or your midwife or your doctor, and just make sure that that's ready, that it's ready to go. Because it's new in some facilities, I have seen that there's sometimes some hiccups in getting it to clients in labor. The other thing is thinking about when to use nitrous. So you would want to use it in that active or transition stage. So usually it's not used in the early stage of labor. It's more inactive when you're really having to work through contractions or, you know, near the end. It seems to be most effective for a shorter amount of time. And so, you know, thinking about using it towards the end of a labor is probably a better strategy, or before you get an epidural could be another strategy for nitrous. The other thing that some people are using nitrous oxide for is during a repair. So if you have an extensive tear or an episiotomy that might take a while to repair, you could ask your care team if you could use nitrous during that repair. So it is just a thought. So definitely something that's becoming more popular. It's definitely a flexible way to use, you know, have pain management. You can still get up, move around. You can still, after you use nitrous, you can stop and still, you know, take advantage of other comfort techniques, unlike an epidural where, you know, you're limited to the bed afterwards, or IV narcotics, which are, sometimes stay in your system and actually prevent you from doing a lot of movement because you don't have, you know, you're not as sharp mentally as you are without an IV narcotic. So it is an option for a lot of people in a lot of places. Do your homework first to see what facilities in your area offer it, if they do, and if there's any restrictions, and if there's any special testing. And leave comments below and let me know your thoughts, questions about nitrous oxide, laughing gas. Have you even had it in a dental procedure? I'd love to know that too. I know I haven't, so more common in some places. Thanks for hanging out with me, you guys. If you are not in the free course, Birth A to Z, I will put a link down below, and it is all of our previous spins all wrapped up into one free course to make it easier to find them. Thanks, like and subscribe to the video, and you'll see the next one tomorrow. Bye, guys.